Good morning, everyone. Where are we? Well, I don't really know. I don't know the name of the cemetery. I can tell you that we are outside of Hahnville, and that we, over there, I don't know if you can see, on the other side of the road is the levee along the Mississippi River. And that is, so we're basically in the river parishes. We are, I guess, northwest of New Orleans. And this cemetery is one that I saw one time when my wife and I were driving. We were just kind of out exploring along the river, driving. And if you ever are in New Orleans or in Louisiana, I definitely recommend a drive along the river, the road closest to the river. Because I feel like there's a lot of New Orleans history, not New Orleans, Louisiana history, that's still kind of evident when you do so. You'll see houses that, in my opinion, were probably slave quarters for families that are still standing. Sometimes they're in the middle of like a sugarcane field or along the road. I don't know for certain that that's what they are, but in the slave quarters that I've seen on some of the plantation properties, which are also along River Road, they are very similarly designed. So, along with the plantations that are still standing, some of them you can tour, some of them are vacant, some of them are abandoned. There are these buildings that look like they're hundreds of years old. And then you have all this industry too, which is along the river, obviously because of the shipping. And then you'll have a cemetery, a peaceful place like this, that's nestled between whatever those are, oil tanks, and whatever that is. And it's just, the imagery is so striking. Contrasting. It's hard to wrap your head around, really. But here we are. So, we're going to do a little bit of exploring today. I don't know what to expect. There's another cemetery. I don't know how far it is from here. I've never been to it before. So when I was making my bucket list of things I want to do before I leave, it was part of it. One of the things I found, so. We're almost exactly a month away from our last day in New Orleans. It's pretty weird, I'll say. I have seen quite a bit of damage on the way here. I wouldn't say it's more or less than what I saw, what I've seen in New Orleans, surrounding areas. But definitely seen it. Here, there's less above ground burial, and it's more, I think these are called Copics. A lot of veterans. Almost apes. Let's fix some of this stuff. How heavy is this gonna be? Oh my god. Not that heavy. There we go. Who's out here all by themselves? This is just an empty one. It's not marked. Doesn't look like anyone's been here to clean up since the storm. Could be wrong. I mean, grass has definitely been mowed. I think that's probably it. We've been fortunate. Haven't had another storm since Ida. Not like last year where we got hit repeatedly. Hurricane season is almost over, but we did get Zeta right before Halloween last year. Spent Halloween in the dark, so that's still a thing. That's unfortunate. A lot of damaged statuary, understandably. Trying to gauge the age of the cemetery. Not sure what the older parts are. A veteran, World War II vet. I think the oldest, here's a 55. Probably the oldest one I've seen so far. These look really old though. I mean, I know they're constantly being weathered. Another World War II vet. Sergeant of the Air Force. Huh. That's unfortunate. I hope they can fix that. I'm sure they can. It's still intact. I don't know if I can lift it. Let's see. No! Granite. ...1987. A lot of French names. Those are probably families that have lived in this area since it was Creole, I imagine. This must be the older part. 50s.
Gotta be careful.
One more two.
Oof, this ground is soft.
Me and more of that.
Super soft.
One more to that. Whoa, super soft.
Wow.
It's nuts. One more two. A lot of veterans here. Solid ground. Feels good. Not sinking. Veteran over here. One more two. This is really pretty. Korean vet. There's not going to be any way to fix that. It sucks. I mean, I'm going to say the damage isn't terrible. Definitely seen worse without a storm. Got a veteran World War I. World War II vet. It's really pretty. Revolutionary soldier. Wow. Take a picture of that. That's cool. Can't quite make that out. This one's in French. The only one I've seen so far. '1903. Almost. World War I vet. Almost 100 years old. Sorry about that, people. There's a crew here working. Whoa, we're at an angle. Sorry about that. World War I vet. Here this week. One vet, and then we have a World War II vet right there. And then over here we got a World War I vet. A lot of vet. I can see a lot of veterans over here. Make our way that way. World War II Champagne. They were probably brothers because they were born less than a year apart. And Theodore and Joseph. And then we have Ernest. Two vet here. really cool. Keeps going from cloudy to all right, so this is from 1967. Okay, so the cemetery dates from 1874. My guess is, I'm gonna make some guesses because I don't know, that there were unmarked burials in here, or burials that no longer had headstones for whatever reason. And maybe it was an indigent cemetery, or something else. And most of these burials happened over existing burials, which is an unpleasant thought. But I don't know. If I'm not, like, the oldest burial I've seen is in the 1920s. It's 50 years after the land was given for burial. So I don't know. I don't know the answer. Do some research. But for one, I can identify the cemetery. Name it. And then maybe we can find out some history. It's so beautiful. I think that's it for this one, folks. Let us move on. On to the next.